So guys, today we are reviewing this 2017 Toyota Innova Crysta 2.4 liter G, which is the base variant. It has 2.4 liter of D40 diesel. It produces around 150 bhp of power and 250 nm of torque. So today we are going to review it. Talk about the engine. Here is the air intake box. Here is the main engine. This is the coolant box. There is a power steering fluid, the engine oil filling cap, the dipstick, the battery is over here, the power steering motor is over there, or the starting motor, washer fluid. And this engine is a 2.4 liter diesel engine which produces around 150 bhp and 250 nm of torque. Here is the insulation that stops a lot of noise which this noisy motor makes. So now let's talk about the grills and other specifications of the car. This is the base variant, so you get the black grill with the silver inserts over here, and there is the big Toyota logo in the middle. There are big air intakes for the intake of air, and to cool the engine, here is the big bump. This is finished in a silver color. Here
also has aftermarket chrome surround for the headlights. There are three parts. It's a parking light, it's a normal beam, and here is the high beam headlight. And you don't get fog lamps on the base model. Here are your the indicators.
So here are these LED flashlights over here, which is actually illegal, but it has. Here is the LED light for the main high beam. For the normal beam, there are halogens, and there is another LED light over here for some running lights. Here is the indicator. So here are the side wing mirrors, which are electrically adjustable from the inside, which has the electrical ORVMs and the indicators mounted on them, and the aftermarket chrome surround for that. Here are the aftermarket chrome door handles. The door handles are actually painted as the body. And here is the side bearing. Here is the aftermarket side step. It has alloy wheels, and it has 16-inch 205/65 R16 radial tires. Now the sun visors, and this car also has tilt on it. This is comfort. Here you have a lot of legroom and a lot of headroom.
Here are the rear seat AC vents and the rear seat AC controls. There is another vent over there. Now here is the legroom. The headroom is about 2 to 3 inches, and here are the adjustable seat belts.
Here are the rear headrests, and you can recline the rear seat, and you also have this sliding function with which you can increase your legroom. Now we are in the third row. There is not a lot of headroom, but for a 5'7" it's very tight. There is headroom, but shoulder room might be tight for 3 people. It's good for 2. You need the seat totally in forward position to get this much legroom. So not recommended for adults. It's for children purpose only. So guys, now let's talk about the rear. There are these beautiful tail lamps. Here is the aftermarket chrome surround for them. The Innova Crysta badging, the Toyota logo in the middle. And this rear wiper, which you also get on the base variant of the car. Here are the rear defoggers. This car gets stock rear spoiler with a third brake light, and it also has a shark fin antenna on the top. Now let's unlock the vehicle. It has an electromagnetic tailgate opener over here. It's not too big, but it perfectly fits this big subwoofer at the back. And it also has good leather seats, which are aftermarket seat covers. And
here is the mat. Here is a subwoofer. It's a 150 liter boot with third row in the place. Without third row, you have around 500 or 600 liters of boot space. Now let's close the boot. Here is the handle to close the boot. This is the aftermarket rear bumper, and here is the reverse light. as standard. Here is there are no steering mounted audio controls, as this is the base variant. Here is the buttons for display and all other settings of the car. Outside temperature is shown over here, that is 26 degrees right now. So guys, here is the instrumental cluster of the vehicle. Here is the temperature gauge of the engine. Here is the rev meter, as you can see. Here is the MID. Here is the speedometer and the fuel gauge over here. Here is the fuel light, that means the fuel is low. Downside for the Odo, you have this button over here which you press and get a trip A, trip B and other kind of things. And for the display, you have a button over here, display right here. It has a aftermarket steering wheel cover. It doesn't get any, what we say, the controls. Here is the horn. Let me show you the features of the display. Now it shows the temperature, which is 31 degrees in Hyderabad outside. Current mileage per 100 kilometers, current liters consumed. The average fuel economy as shown is 7.7 liter per 100 kilometers, which is range is 32 kilometers, average speed is 31 kilometers, elapsed time is 93.08, eco mode and other settings. Now we come on to here. Here is the time, hazard light switch, and here is the aftermarket touchscreen, which doesn't have many features. But here is the CDA jack, the volume up, volume down, turn on and turn off, pause, volume down, and home. Here is a USB drive. Here are other things, Bluetooth, wheel controls and other things. And here are the manual AC controls, temperature setting, the fan speed and the pumps, airflow, AC button over here, recycling. Here you have the airbag light for the passenger is off, eco mode and power mode. You also can see that on the display. Yeah, now let me show you eco mode. Eco mode is now on. Now it's in normal mode. Now it's in power mode, as you can see. Here is a charging port where you have insert a charger. It has a 5-speed manual transmission, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and reverse. It also has a reverse horn and a reverse parking camera with sensors. It has one cup hold over here. There is a handbrake. So here is the outside rear view mirror with dimming and other feature. Here is the lights which you turn on from like this. Here are the sunglass holder. Here is how the instrumental cluster looks like when the lights and all are on.
Now let's check out the passenger side. Yeah, here is the power window control. Here is another thing for the cup holder. Here is the secondary glove box. Here is the another cup holder, AC vent. It has two airbags.
Yeah, here is the secondary glove box and the glove box. Here is also a defogger. There is this blank switch.
So here we have the chrome door handle for the inside. There are the internal locks. Here we have four power windows. One is the driver side is the auto down. The other three are normal. Here is the central locking. Here are the power window locks, and this is for the outside rear view mirror control. Here you have an integrated door handle. Here you have a cup holder and some space for the files and other things. Here is a reflector down here. Here are the integrated door steps that are aftermarket.
So guys, thanks for watching the video. Please do like, share, subscribe and hit the bell notification icon on the channel.